the headphones so that hopefully they make the sound even better for you guys. So that's the plan. Okay, everything appears to be set up right. Here. Thank you for everyone that's joined so far. We are, yeah, obviously sharing needs to happen because I do have two that go live automatically, but I forgot to do the sharing because of the stress yesterday, and we're already doing as good or better than yesterday. So, I was just checking something quickly. That's what I thought. Sounds good, Kid Chasma. Okay, that's what I thought. I was just trying to remember from stuff I learned in school. So I actually got my, almost have my HR, master's in HR. And then I had to stop because of a lot of things going on in life. But we learned a little bit about some cultures, Japanese being one of them, and the very, so Japanese are on time to a little bit early. Russians are way late. And it's just the culture. Japanese are very business oriented. How do we serve the company? You know, they serve the whole. Kind of the ask not what your country can do for you, but ask what you can do for your country that some people live by in the US. Basically, everyone in Japan, you represent your ancestors. And you would never do anything to bring a bad name to them. In Russia, if you start an hour or two late, it's slowly changing, but we were told, don't be surprised for that to happen. Don't be in a rush. Rush is very much about the relationship, building relationships, whereas Japan is about the business. Don't ask about family, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It takes a long time for a Japanese to trust you enough to share that information. It can take, as we read in the thing, 10 plus years, before you even may even know if they have children. So, but at the same time, so part of it is this. In general, in Japan, once you're hired somewhere, you will work there for the rest of your life. How you do your job depends on what type of job you will have for the rest of your life. If you're really good and you put your, you work hard, et cetera, you will rise in the company. If not, you may be sidelined to the bottom floor, to the basement, basically, in a room that's basically a closet, doing work that, like stuffing envelopes or stuff. That really the company doesn't care if you complete or not, because they don't know if you will. So it can make all the difference in the world to your employment if you are how you work. And not just here in the US, oh, I don't like what's going on, whatever, I can leave, or I don't like that, how that employee's acting, I can fire them. Very few people ever get fired in Japan. It takes quite a lot to do so. So rather, they try to make them want to quit. And so you can imagine, and a lot of people, why would they quit? Because if they quit trying to find another job, that tells those employers that they were sidelined, basically, and made to want to quit. So it can be very difficult to get a new job. So why would you quit? So many people, or many times, they'll just deal with it. Well, obviously, that attitude portrait comes through their work. Work is everything to, not everything, but work me your position, et cetera. Just, in the US, we look up to those in to CEOs, stuff like that often. But unlike in the US, from what I've heard, Japanese don't look at it, the big bosses trying to rip them off. It's look at how good of a life he lives. So, that's what I've been led to understand, at least. In the way I see it, this lady, she's probably in her, at this time, in her maybe in her like 30s. Maybe late mid 20s, probably mid 20s, because she hasn't been married yet. Well, actually, maybe in her 30s. I don't know. 20s or 30s. And she holds a good position. She's moved her way up in the business a lot. Enough that Amy has heard of her and has heard enough to make, with what she just said, to make, or what she said when she realized, hey, I'll find someone ready to lead, or, I'll give you suggestions of people who should lead, whatever. Amy knew that that was enough to confirm to Amy what she had heard and make a decision that she has suggested to her father that we haven't heard what it is yet.
Yet 1:30. Give me another 15 minutes. Okay. Yes.
Not quite sure what that means. I'm assuming that you pocket typed that to Gasma. Hi, caged animal. Thank you for joining. Hi, Shree. Hershley. I don't want Ben. Would Ben to figure out? No. Or would have Ben to figure out? No, it's not in the past. We're talking current. Would be there. Amy. That frustrated me, and now I lost what I was thinking. Now, let's see, where is it gonna go from here? I'm gonna open this while I think. Oh, okay. That goes in my car. Okay, so right now we are, I think the 13th. The last two people that have been bitten in the UK have actually been both inducted into the pack. I hadn't expected to do that. Especially because this is now going to provide, they're going to have to wait a little bit because they're, if their plan goes through, the pack in Japan's going to jump pretty quickly and they're going to need to be able to provide for that. They're already providing Wolfsbane in the UK basically at cost. Looking at expanding that to everywhere, and actually kind of in some ways are, if people contact them. Aha, that's where we're gonna go with this. Where? I'm trying to find my lid. I was getting ready for when I, or yeah, for the rest of my breakfast. When I got on, I'd eaten one sandwich and still needed to eat my other one, or get my other one ready and eat it. Just got it ready. But I seem to have misplaced the lid. For the mayo, and that's not a good thing. Obviously, we need a mayo lid on the mayo. I'm not quite sure how I misplaced it. If it slipped into a bag or what? Aha, found it. No wonder. Every time I moved on to it. And I kept thinking, I'm feeling it. Like the mayo on my pants, but I couldn't figure out where it was coming from. Okay. Trying to get my water ready too.
Where do you want this?
In the bathroom. I usually put it on the right side of the toilet, between the toilet and the tub. Bye. No, I want friends, and I'm not going to change that, no matter how much you yell at me for it. I am the Connor. So what I'm writing is actually it's set in the Wizarding World in 2019, and the I thought, well, what if werewolves were more like some of the werewolves from the werewolf stories, so they can, well, first off, I thought, what could I write? And as I thought about it, I thought JKR's description of werewolves didn't sit right with me, because they wouldn't be able to reproduce enough. Eventually, they would die out. Which just, and so I went, okay, so what explanation might we have that would explain being able to, that would work to explain a way that werewolves wouldn't die out, but yeah. So then I thought of the way that a lot of people write werewolves, where they're in a pack and they can and they can shift at any time of the any time they want, with permission of the pack of the alpha. So the alpha can prevent it. And well, if that were to happen, what would happen if you weren't allowed to shift? Well, that would make you crazy. So what would happen if the only time you could shift was the full moon? You'd go bats, and you wouldn't be in control of yourself on the full moon. Well, what if that was the only werewolves that that the Wizarding World had ever known were those who weren't in a pack? So they would go crazy on the full moon. That started to make sense. Well, why wouldn't the Wizarding World know about them? Well, why don't Muggles know about the Wizarding World? What if there was a pack in the UK that, because of treatment of werewolves and whatever, and between infighting between packs, you know, the danger of a one pack attacking another, and then the danger from the outside world, both from Muggles and from wizards and from the magical world, that basically kind of got hidden their identity from the world. And what if they had actually been able to hide their identity? They had been so good they'd been able to hide their identity, and just those packs who hadn't had been wiped out. Okay. There's an, and then what if one of those children was born with magical powers and was invited to join Hogwarts? What would happen? And I'm a discovery writer, so that's where I started writing. So far, she's met Newt started to realize he was off on his figuring of werewolf a few years before, but couldn't figure it out. And right as he was, and then they disappeared. Well, he later met with my main character and realized she moved right when his werewolves disappeared. And she was living in the area that his werewolves disappeared from. And so he asked her, when she was by herself, and she admitted to it, and he pulled him in to help her help every werewolf in the magical community, because by then she knew the danger werewolves were in from the magical community. So she domesticated a phoenix. Early, before she was 8 years old, she's friends with Harry and Potter. She's now friends after starting at Hogwarts with Harry and Ginny Potter's daughter, Lily. She has a friend who's another friend who she actually made a number of years ago, like right after she moved, who's also magical. That friend had actually gone to Muggle school. Her and her father had decided to set her or her mother and her father had decided to send their kids to Muggle school so they would know how to fit in better with the Muggle population. Hi, the real salties. And so there's that. And she's working on helping out werewolves throughout the world while being the future alpha of her pack, so the future leader of her pack, and attending Hogwarts with no one knowing she's, or with very few people knowing she's a werewolf. It is kind of a fan fiction. A lot of people are. It's kind of one of those, a lot of people with fan fiction is they adjust the actual story right then, or they use those immediate characters. We have heard almost nothing about Lily Potter, and she's the closest to one of the main characters in my story. But even then, she's not the main character. I am using some things like Lily is Harry and Ginny's daughter, and her two other brothers are at school there. I did say cursed child, the reason no one, I don't think so. We are at 89 pages. And I need to look into it more. I think, from what I understand, I will be able to. I'm going to look into it more. But from what I understand, you need at least a 25% change in the story. And mine's so far different that I don't think there's going to be a problem, but I'm not sure. I can't say. I do use, I talk about Harry and Ginny and Hermione and Ron a couple times, but just as in, I think you can keep them as long as your, especially JKR at one point said people could use her world and write stories in her world. They just couldn't write about her main characters. Like she couldn't, they couldn't take her main characters and if I remember right, she said they couldn't write future. I can't remember either. She didn't want any future stories about her main characters, but they could her kids, or they like, or that they couldn't go right off when she left. That it would have to be down in the future. So that's part of what I need to check is if you can use some of the characters as long as they're side characters. Does that make sense? And that's the only thing I'm not sure of. But I'm not even really doing it for selling it right now. I have had some viewers want me to at least publish it. But one thing I've said is we'll get to that point once the story's done. We will then edit it and try and find out the rules and everything else. Some of that looking would be online. If not, if we can't sell it, I think you can, or there are some rules about the ways you, some things we might be able to do to get around that to at least allow some people to have a published book. But I'm not sure. I just haven't had the time or desire yet to really go into that. And honestly, so Newt is taking the biggest. I have not. Actually, the thing that Real Salty, the Real Salty's brought up is part of the reason I think part of the reason I'm doing it in docs. One, I know how to use docs and I don't have to adjust. But two, then if there is an issue with me using the characters, I don't have to worry about some app having grabbed it and or about some of the details with some of the other apps. Or and stuff where either they publish regularly or different things like that. Basically, I'm not going to do any, I'm not going to make it available to the public other than this way while I'm writing it. My understanding is as I'm writing it, nothing really can be said because it's like writing a fan fiction or whatever, and fanfics can be put out there, they just can't be sold. So as I'm writing it, that's one thing. But then once it's done and finished, what happens with it is where the real question comes in. So this way, there's no question. This way, right now, the only quote quote earnings are from people watching me write the book. And I don't think anyone can that they'll really do anything about that because it's really the writing process and whatever. Unless I was pushing. Hey, come watch me write this Harry Potter book. At the same time, it's kind of like it's the same as I'm playing Wizards Unite on stream. And I, you know, and I'll probably play like the Lego Harry Potter games on stream, and a few things like that. So I feel that right now we're safe. Once the boot, and even in the editing process, we'll be safe. Even if the channel starts taking off and gets a lot of subscribers and whatever, I feel it's the same as every other Twitch streamer out there, just streaming what they're doing. But then if I were to take it, complete it, and publish it, to do that, I would need to, completing it is one thing, but then how do I publish it is going to be the question. Is do I have to publish it as a fanfic, like on a fanfic site or something, where there's no nothing ever paid? Or what? I mean, and I'm pulling this up for a reason. If I can find what I'm after. So, this one's the official Harry Potter baking book. I don't know if they paid for that to be called the official. There's other recipe books. There's links to like this academic, that probably the academic year planner probably does have a license. The unofficial Harry Potter cookbook. How are they publishing this? Did they pay royalties or not? Or what about the cocktail book? And so I'm not sure. I'm just, I'm going to wait and see. Because I think, because there is a point of, I don't know where that line is, because I know you also can, they can't claim, there's certain things they can and can't claim rights to, if that makes sense. So I don't know, can they, yeah, I don't know the rules there. Obviously, if you're using the name Harry Potter, I'm sure for like that way. But like, what about this one? I can't see someone paying for rights for something like this. And there is a possibility of, and I just, like I said, this is some of the stuff we would have to look into. I wouldn't, I obviously wouldn't just put it up and then wait to be slammed. I would do the research on what do I need to pay for if I do. What's allowed, what's not, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And I know it's not necessarily, she did give, well, that's just it. JKR in one of her interviews actually said people were free to use the wizard to write stories in the wizarding world. I mean, obviously it's not going to come up in a quick search. I was hoping it would, but she did give people permission to write stories in her world. And to, well, the way she indicated was even, publish them and whatever. So I'm going to need to look into it more. Because the difference, there's no way you could write a different setting, because that's a big part of it is the, you'd have to, the things you would have to change to write it in a different setting, you'd basically be writing a different book. You'd basically your setting, what's the rules of your world are what guides how your world works. And so if you change the rules, you change everything about the book. And that's one reason you kind of have to know the rules of your world as you write it. Even if, so I do discovery writing, but I have to understand the rules of the world to write discovery writing because I need to know what can happen and what can't? And so, I have had to, or some of it, obviously, the world she wrote in was the 90s and before. I'm writing in 2019. Rules have changed in the world, just like, their world has changed, just like our world has changed. I am using, so part of it also, Wizards Unite is active in my world. It's really happening in my world in 2019. And so, when you take those into consideration, yeah, and it's basically going to be when we're done finding out about it. So I need to find out on Wizards Unite if I'm just saying that they're playing it and how I'm explaining that it works. Do I really need to, what goes on there? If I'm saying that they're the parents and they're, I'm giving information that's given in Wizards Unite, that Hermione's the Minister of Magic and then have them meet with her for like a paragraph or for a couple paragraphs where you very little hear about them. There's no descriptions of them, anything else other than what there? What about Luna and Professor Longbottom? So Neville. What about Headmistress McGonagall? Headmistress McGonagall shows up a couple times. Neville's teaching classes at Hogwarts. Professor Binns teaching classes at Hogwarts. Let's see who else is teaching. That she's written in. Neville, Binns, Hagrid's still at Hogwarts, and Flitwick's still at Hogwarts. We have not run, we've maybe barely run into Flitwick. We have not run into Hagrid at all yet in the story. I can't say if we will or not. But Luna and Rolf are there. I am writing about Lorcan and Lysander. They've come in a bit. So has Hugo and Hugo's sister has, I just, or Hugo's been named, and so has Lily's older brothers. I mentioned Cursed Child. I mentioned that the reason people don't understand Cursed Child is that it was cursed. People were trying to prevent the magic. Some people were trying to prevent the Muggles from reading anything about the wizarding world, and they cast a spell on it, and it made it so that no one could understand at all what was happening in Cursed Child. And so basically, everything in Cursed Child is that we read is due to a spell. We don't know what the true story there is. That's what I mention about Cursed Child. I talk about how that spell was then adjusted, put on, that it was adjusted and cast on the Wizards Unite, and so that only magical individuals, those who have or could access it and would have fun, but that those who were not invited to magical schools could still utilize it and help return confoundables. So, yeah, it's going to totally become in the end. Finish writing it, edit it, get that done, and then do the research on what needs to happen. Because I don't know who else. Fox is in here. Fox is Lily's Phoenix now. Sounds good. And it, I don't always write. I play Wizards Unite when there's an event going on. So like Monday at least we'll be playing, maybe Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. I do some art, usually based on stream. So I'm just going to show you the first one is Amy, who's the main character, and the second one is Luna and Lysander's house. So basically, we will see what happens. Like I said, once it's edited, we'll do the research and find out where we need to go from there. Unless someone reaches out to me sooner and says, "Hey, I've done the research. Here's where you can go look it up. Here's what you need to do, whatever else to, if you want to publish it." Or, and this would be way ridiculous, but if JKR were to reach out and be and give me the rights to use everything I'm using. Now that would be in my mind an almost non-possibility, but I am going to say if that someone with the ability to give the rights were to reach out and say, "Hey, we like it enough that we're going to give you the rights, or we'll give you the, or we'll publish you even." And here's what the agreement we'll make for the publishing, and we'll take care of all of that. I definitely have to look into that. But otherwise, like I said, we'll do a lot of the research on stream while I, once things are ready. But until then, first of all, in my mind, it's we've got to finish it, and I've got to have it to where I'm happy with it before I even look into those things, because who knows could happen between now and then. And I prefer to put the work into the writing right now. So, I hate when it does that. Okay. We are going to there. Aha, there it is. I forgot where it was. Just seeing if I put in the schedule here. And I just saw your posture check. So I just did. There we go. I thought I'd put that in. Hi, crafting with with Ray or Ray. I keep forgetting you say just Ray, to just call you Ray. I'm doing okay. Oh, okay.
Good feeling. We need it.
I'm sorry, just putting doing your fingers like that really confused me. Yeah. So he just came in and ran his fingers around and around and around, and I'm like, huh? But yeah. Okay, we're back. Sorry about that. I think the internet had issues due to the rain. So I'm sorry. Hopefully, yeah, I'm glad it's back soon. If we do lo keep losing, I may end up getting off because it is raining. So I'm sure that's what's causing the issues. But at least we're able to keep going right now. I'm going to hurry and try and get the schedule done, and then we're going to see who we can raid and raid because obviously we're cutting in and out. I'm sorry. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to hurry and finish putting dinner in here. I'm then going to leave you guys with it where it is. We're going to do this. We're going to do this. I will, on my own, work out the schedule. That way you guys don't have to sit around for it. I will figure out what things that her family and friends are going to ask of her. So I will be getting a little ways on the page as I figure out, but I will stop as soon as the schedule's done. I will have her send a letter to her friends telling them that she needs to hear from them what they would like, whatever. So basically giving her friends the same request. I'll get the schedule together and I will see you guys on Monday. We will be doing adversary event Monday. I've kind of planned Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday for adversary event. But if we get done sooner, we get done sooner. I did do one art stream for next week because there were obviously people who wanted to do the art stream but didn't vote for the art stream. They only voted on the thing, so I will put in an art stream. One art and one writing next week. If we do get more days, we can maybe put those up for vote. Also, check the memes in the Discord. There was a funny one that I added there. So there's the link to the Discord. I am going to quickly go to my page where I can find who's on and everything else. There's my stream manager open. Now let's see. Okay. We have Tammy V on. I'm not promising we're gonna go there. I'm just stating that that's who's live on my without going in my Discords. Now we're going to check my Discords. Okay, we have one playing Apex Legends there. And that one's just me. This one's also Apex Legends. In fact, it's the same person. We have a bonus stream, so I'm gonna see what they're streaming. Forza Motorsport 7. The Binding of Isaac Rebirth is also one. Dead by Daylight, which I won't raid into ever. At least, well, I can't promise I won't ever, but I prefer not to. Okay, I think. I know it's been a while since we did raid this person. She's in two of my different Discords stating she's live. I'm going to just double check. Unless someone says they do not want Apex Legends, I think we will raid her. I'm waiting for these ads to finish so I can make sure. Just in case. It does look like if we watch Apex Legends, there is the possibility of a Twitch drop by that. Get load screen 6 by watching her play Apex Legends. And just there are some other rewards. So Just because she's in a few of the groups that do come in and support a lot, I think we will go support her just for a, yeah. Be aware, it is a game that I usually won't stay around for. So I'll probably put her on lurk in the background. I prob but it, just in case some of you guys are interested, then at least you can see it. And I will see you guys Monday.